Water. your pilot barge?
Me?
Right here.
Well, our hope is to put the first one right here.
Got it. Strategically located.
So our absorbers are made out of recycled plastic, and that's the key thing that's different from all the other absorbers that you see in the industry. It's a very large industry, but a poorly unique one on that basis. We have lots of other products that go along with it. I'm just showcasing these two for you. Near the scope. The other project that we have is 24/7 Blue. I'll let you go ahead and tell you the 24/7
Blue. Okay, so back in the day, we had generated ways to optimize the growth of microbial biofilms. Microbial biofilms are used in water irrigation all the time, but they're rarely used in a way where you create a biofilm and harvest it in a timely manner. So by harvesting biofilms when they're nice and fat, you are increasing your uptake of heavy metals and other contaminants in the water. And those biofilms are then put into conversion systems so they don't have to go into toxic waste. We're just creating more green energy from it. One of the nice things with how biofilms work, so think of it as like a frat boy party, right? So you have a single frat boy, he's out in the world looking for a home, and he finds a beautiful surface. Well, what microbes do is they send out signals to all their little buddies, and they're like, hey, guess what?
So this comes to real-time mapping and getting the pulse on water quality. So that, to me, is the most fascinating part about what we're proposing as far as is knowing what's happening in the water table with real-time sensors, real-time mapping, so that you can deploy these systems quickly. The barge itself, as Gray mentioned, is comprehensive, and we had a floating island that was going to be delivered here today for this demo, but it got stuck in transit. But these systems are basically islands that can do the same thing. They have microorganisms that collect on them and that make them more efficient. And they can be planted with specialized species that can be hyperaccumulators. They can take up heavy metals. You can harvest those heavy metals and sell them to places that are efficient. The BOT system, as shown here, can potentially even be used for lithium, which is a very expensive process right now. We're going to be testing that with USD to see if it's possible. But we assume that we can pick up pretty much anything with those reactors. The real role that I wanted to kind of share today is that it also picks up microplastics. And these systems, as well as the islands, and the whole system is actually taking up microplastics, taking those systems, repurposing them, and making them into new products. And so it's a circular loop where it keeps getting better and more efficient and less cost and more carbon reduction with every cycle.
So after things have been made at the barge, and we have our irrigation system that we put in place, then we have our conversion facility that we have. And you can put anything into a pyrolysis conversion if you're going to electricity. You don't have to have a really optimized feedstock like you do if you're going into fuels. So by doing that, we can take everything coming off of these barges that include all of those heavy metals and all of those plastic contaminants, the plant material, the plastic material, MSW if the vessels want to get rid of their waste from their vessels, tires that are coming in to transport vessels, so instead of going to landfill, we'll be taking them and using them for energy content. And then all of that goes into energy that can be put into ship for power, but the carbon char can be gathered. So say you have an area with a high amount of lithium, you put in all your waste materials from these products in there, and then in your carbon char, you have lithium that you pull out of it. So there's a lot of recovery in this type of process, as well as the circularity. And carbon black, just if you're looking at steel coming from tires, that all things that can be put back into the marketplace. So it's not just the do good, it's the do good for the market.
Yeah, I'll just say we want to use shipping containers because it's an obvious solution, right? You save money. All of these can be shipping container design structures that are easily adaptable. They're mobile. They can be assembled. They can be relocated on demand. And to us, that's the ideal flexibility. Same thing with the barge. If there's an urgency and there's an oil spill 100 yards away, this thing can unmoor, go down there, and start cleaning the water. It's not just a monitoring lab. It's actually a filtration system. And it's an active ecosystem, it's mobile. And so that the most important part of this for me is that these economic systems can start investing in larger carbon projects and other investment opportunities for the port, but also for other jurisdictions that might be interested in larger carbon investments through our Blue Capital and our collaborative teams with Aegis and Blue Sorbents and many other companies. So our real goal is that you don't just hit 1x, you hit 2x, 3x, 5x, and the quicker you hit those margins, the quicker you can reinvest in the next project and start hitting those margins even faster, because the barge doesn't change. Any questions? Any ideas? Are we ready to deploy? Let's go.
Yes.
It's fine. That's always the one. Yeah. You have got that around the corner as the rollout, right? I do have a question. So obviously port authorities, government organizations, and then I can also see there is some sort of a, let's just call it a dirty operation that's by the water. It would be great to have one of these in place. Any other commercial models, like any other customers that you see?
So you can apply these anywhere that someone's got a product that's going to Europe. So say it's a candy company that is shipping things to Europe. Well, they're responsible for greenhouse gas reductions that are being transferred by that vessel. So you could do it with anywhere within their supply chain. It could be in the middle of the desert. It could be at the port operations. But the nice thing is you're going to create excess amounts that these companies need. So when they come to us and they have a contract, they buy at a set price where it's inflating at a small rate. And we know that the attestations last year in Europe went from $50 last year to $70 today. So it's going up really quickly. So they buy from us at a set price, and any excess they can sell to their buddies if it's at a transport center, because it's still part of the infrastructure of their supply chain.
Somebody was mentioning earlier about fishing operations, aquaculture, that are happening in the oceans. These are kind of the section modulus, right? You can have a bob system hanging below an island, hanging around sorbents, and you could use them in multiple different variations. So if you imagine there's a fish aquaculture operation, you can surround these. You can do it at an oil drilling platform. Think about deep water horizon, right? You can start actually treating and extracting stuff and doing phytoremediation without flocculants and chemicals. And we also talked about dredging operations that start to bring heavy metals and chemicals into the water quality table, that you can start mitigating those and have it be complementary to the operation.
That's great. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Appreciate your time.
Yeah, cheers.
And look, it's done. All the whale's gone.
I'm not going to head down to the dock.
So these are an actual product that we see.
things that I remember seeing you last year, and you had a buoy for a boy to the system that then opened it. So now you've gone to the next level. Tell us about it.
Yeah. Hi, everybody. My name is Michael Aarons. I'm founder and CEO at Creator Brokers. One of the two robots that you'll see in the water right now is what we call our broker system. And it's essentially a Roomba for the water boats. So it's a small autonomous and remote controlled vessel. Right now it's actually driving itself.
For sure,
so,
they're a huge customer to get in with
it. And it is just following
and everything else that we have. And then get us to do the presentation.
This vessel is meant to act as a dredging boat for the water. So one of the ways that we're currently managing the pollution in our waterways is going to be the best to capture a lot of cities here in San Jose. All around the coastline of our contractors have dredging boats.
Open shoreline of the waterway, oil spill cleanups, could you partner with these guys and have one of these? They call it a pod in your back.
Of course. So there is four extra points on the river for the carabiner in place. And if you can drag up to a normal rate of oil spill, depending on whether we're using air flies or something else,
very curious about.
Thank you. process.
Hi there, thank you for having me. We got our demo started already. We're demonstrating today the blue boat on that surface vessel. It's actually out there in Sweet Smells. It's doing a waypoint mission and it's going to draw out the new creative logo. So at the end of this, we'll be able to show you the map of the creative logo. Dynamite. And then they blow up dynamite in the water, they cause the fish bladder to nerve wise. to the surface, kills the fish. And their ability to detect which direction those things came from so that they can alert authorities and send that to the people. All sorts of different issues. The company I'm with is Blue Robotics, and we've been around for about 10 years now. Our specialty is building all of these components and systems to low cost. We started with the thruster motor, which is what's propelling this vehicle. Back in 2014, we launched a Kickstarter campaign with 600 thrusters and raised $100,000 in Kickstarter. And now we have 350 different products in our store. We have two flagship products. One is this vehicle, which we started selling last year.
I should probably.
We offer the other vehicle,